You're watching Electrical Engineering Lectures channel. For more videos, please do like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for the latest notifications.
Hi viewers, this is a short video presentation on comparison between PIC Microcontroller and Arduino UNO. PIC Microcontroller is a family of microcontrollers made by Microchip. They are mostly sold as chips and we need to put them on a circuit board by a ZIF socket and a few cables. Also, external programmers like PICKit 2 or PICKit 3 are needed to program the microcontroller using MPLABX IDE. The software has less libraries as compared to Arduino. Arduino, however, is very cost effective compared to PIC. And it comes under open source hardware. Cross platforms are also available as you can program it on Windows, Linux, and Mac. While most of the PIC microcontrollers are only programmable in Windows setup. The programming environment is very easy to use even for the beginners. The library of examples is also present in IDE. So all you need is a USB cable, Arduino software, and Arduino board. Let us discuss the components of Arduino UNO board. The first one is a reset button. It is used to restart any code that has been loaded on the Arduino board. Labeled as 2 are the analog reference pins that are used to set an external reference voltage. Number 3 is a ground pin. There are few ground pins in the Arduino board and they all work the same. From pin 0 to pin 13 are digital pins that can be used as input or output depending upon the functionality you require. All you need is to mention the functionality inside the Arduino code. Labeled as 6 is a USB connector, which is used to connect the Arduino board with the computer so that it gets the power to be plugged in, and also the transfer of the program from software to hardware is made possible. Number 7 are the transmitter and receiver LEDs. They indicate the transmission and reception of the data during the process. 8th one is the most important component. It is the Atmega microcontroller that is the brain of the board. All the programs are stored here. Number 9 is the indicator whether your board is plugged in or not. To control the input power, you can see a potentiometer labeled as 10. To provide 3.3 or 5 volt voltage output to the project that you are working with, you can use the pins labeled as 12 and 13 in this diagram. There is also a privilege of analog input in the Arduino board that is labeled here as 15. Now we will discuss how we can simulate the Arduino project inside the Proteus simulation. The first thing is to add the Arduino libraries in your Proteus. It is a simple procedure. You have to go to the link in the description of this video, download and extract the files from there, paste the library files in your C drive, program data, lab central electronics, the Proteus folder, and finally the library folder. The first step to write an Arduino code is to write a sketch file. The sketch file contains the instructions that tell microcontroller what to do. There are two important components of every sketch file. The first one is setup, and it is used to set up the things that happen once only and they are not to be repeated. The second component is the loop, and it contains the instructions to be repeated over and over again until the board is turned off. We will discuss our first example code of Arduino and Proteus simulation in the next video. Stay tuned. Thank you.